Can you try to speak?
Testing 1, 2, 3. Can I sit here? Am I in the camera or?
You have to go a bit to the right.
So you went.
Yeah, that way, perfect.
And so I guess that makes me a dinosaur. That's the dinosaur show.
that in purpose. I told you about that. And through a contact of mine from when I was actually doing Drupal websites almost a decade ago, he's the CTO at a startup, and I have been talking with him for over a year now, just networking. And he decided that I was their new director of engineering, and I went through the interview process, and I started about a month ago. And it's amazing. I'm having a blast. I'm not coding right now, but I still get to architect. I get to facilitate communication. I get to plan. I get to oversee the work and get a say in how things are done without actually having to do some of the nitty-gritty. So it's very, very different, but I'm enjoying it. And so it's actually really cool to also get back into the code. So, moving on. What is Redwood? Well, we're going to talk about that. So this next slide is their homepage. I thought it was a really cool image. And what it says is you're going to focus on building your startup, not fighting your framework. And it really is this scalable full-stack framework. And the tutorial, by the way, is great. They have some videos to go along with the first several of the sections. Really excellent documentation. So, Redwood itself, what is it? It is a full-stack framework designed to help you grow from side project to startup. Said that. It was founded by Preston-Werner, who was ex-CTO at GitHub. There were three other co-founders whose names escaped me, but it was built by some people who have been there, done that, know a thing or two about coding. One of the really fun things about it, as you can see, is it has these technologies out of the box, already integrated, and so it's opinionated. It is an opinionated framework. You don't get to decide, oh, I don't want GraphQL, I want REST. There's actually another framework out from T3 app, which uses TRCP instead.
TRPC and Next.
Yeah, and REST. But a lot of this, it uses Next.js for the front end. A lot of the rest of it is the same. But this is GraphQL. I like GraphQL. I think it's fun. And using, you're going to see the code generators, you don't really have to write very much of it. It kind of writes itself. And one of the best things is the community is actually really, really warm and supportive. There's Discord, which I joined. I asked a bunch of questions. I got timely and constructive answers, a lot of dialogue back and forth, and really helped me understand some things and make some good choices. You're all wondering, but how's it compared to Next, right? Because what really is the difference? All right, well, let's talk about that. All right, so, and Next is minimalistic, comparatively, okay? And it gives you these server-side rendered React applications. Still server-side and serves JavaScript, not the same as something like Quick or Astro. There's a big distinction there. And I think I think that's the future, but we'll see when that becomes completely mainstream. I'm very curious about that. Now these next quotes are from the Versa website. So, zero setup, use the file system as an API. Cool, we love that about Next. Everything's a function, nice. Server-side rendering, and code splitting, of course, because it's 2023. And data fetching is up to the developer, but there's lots. You'll find 10,000 videos on YouTube on how to do this. Shouldn't be a problem using just fetch. It's fast, everyone likes that. And it's really great for spinning up a proof of concept or MVP over the weekend. Would you really want to just take that and then try to scale it into a startup? I'm sure it's been done, not by me. I haven't done it with Redwood either, by the way, just something clever. By the way, the quotes are from Purcell, as I said. Now, Redwood is an opinionated full-stack serverless web application framework. Opinionated. It's got page code splitting, got the rendering, and this is where we start to get to the really awesome stuff. Powerful CLI. You can, if you're, it is said by Dr. Chris, if you are creating files manually using Redwood, you're doing it wrong. Use the generators. They not only create files, they write half the code for you, as you're going to see. You can install UI libraries, which we're going to do, authentication, you can deploy, you can create pages, components, layouts, backend services, you can do things with Prisma, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. And so I think it's ideal for startups looking for a little more, I'm not sure what I said, complexity, and it makes it really, really much simpler to scale without having to start from scratch with a new framework. And like I said, there are a couple of things which make Redwood special, and they are the CLI, which we're gonna see a lot in depth. This concept called cells, which I will get to in a few minutes. You'll be curious to know what that is, I'm sure. And the community, as I mentioned before. So, here's a partial list, and there's even another page of this, of what the CLI can do. So, of course, you can create your app. You can, let me get a thing over here. You can deploy service functions to or netify anywhere you want. Usually, not anywhere, but with a command, with a CLI command. You can generate these cells I mentioned, components. You can do migrations. Generate the authentication. It builds the pages for you. Do you know how boring that is to build these pages manually? I think it's boring. One line of code. Serverless functions. Layouts page, scaffolding, which we'll get to in a second, SEL, which is the GraphQL schema, and service objects, you can do the service object on its own. Scaffolding builds it all up. Your entire CRUD and your list page and your detail page in one command. And if your Prisma model has relations, it won't build the UI. Like if you have posts, blog posts, and you have users for the author, it won't give you a drop down for the user, but in the CRUD, you can do that yourself with just pulling the GraphQL, just pulling the ID and the name from your database, and then you just turn it into a drop down. I tried that earlier today. So moving on, what else can you do? Some of the setup, you can set up the auth, deploy. This is the prepare for the deployment. You can create a TS config and then start creating types in there or your type rules. You can turn on, you can install Postgres and hook in, create your Tailwind UI in one line, which makes it really easy to prototype stuff. And of course, you can type checking and upgrade. So cells, what are these cell things of which you speak? So cells are a declarative approach to data fetching. This is really, really basic, right? So if you can do, yarn, redwood, generate, cell, the name of your cell, and it'll just create it for you. If you use a plural, it will assume you want multiples. If you use singular, it will assume you only want the one, and if it's a word which you can't really tell, because it's a fish, then you can use the list flag, and it will you can tell which one you want. But all we're doing is we're pulling the type of the GraphQL query, because we like GraphQL extracting types. Cells, right. Cells have four states at minimum, four constants: loading, empty, failure, success. And so when you are looking at a cell, you're looking at a list of blog posts. No matter what, it's going to, until the query has returned anything, you get empty. Or until it started. And there are actually these lifecycle before query, after query, things like this. So when it's loading, you'll see this. Often it's so fast you won't see it. If there's a problem, you can tell it what to show if there's a problem. And then what to do when it returns successfully. And it's all done kind of for you. You can change what fields you have, change how they're displayed. You can put another component right here if you want. And it's really kind of that simple to get lists of things onto your page. Community, as I mentioned, they're super warm. This is their own quote. And this will be available later. Discord/RedwoodJS, Twitter/RedwoodJS, and their forums, which are also have a ton of great information, community.redwoodjs.com. And so, now for the book. We're just gonna, you let me guys know, let me know if it starts to get boring, because you know, a lot of coding, I don't know if it's that exciting for you all, but it's fun to see how fast we can go just by coding.
So we're going to build a Storybook, right?
Build a what?
A Storybook.
Startup, yes. No, we're going to work on building a blog post. So I'm going to close that. So what I've already done is I created, just before I created, used the create app for Redwood, and this is it out of the box, so I can now go, this is just gonna start it up. Oop, because I already have one going. One second, which one is, no, yes. Cool. It just starts working. And it gives you your links to wherever you want to go. Okay, well, that's nice and more or less useless. So what are we gonna do next? I have like a list of things. How are we gonna do this? So we're gonna install Tailwind, right? Cool. This problem. So this is a modern flow with web for the front end and API for the back end. So you can configure it here. Public is assets you're depending on serving. Source, you have components, nothing yet. Layout, something yet. Pages, they give you a, you know, page out founder out of the box. That's nice. This is the routes, which currently has nothing, but you're going to see when we build stuff out, gets added here automatically, which is really, really convenient. Over here, we have Prisma schema, which is what they start with. And you'll see directives. These are GraphQL directives. We're going to look at those today. This is just your middleware, which we're also not going to touch today. No GraphQL SDLs yet. Has a logging built in. You have to set it up, but that's fine. Let's try it again. It's basic auth functions, basic DB functions. Services, this is where your business logic is going to live. Obviously, this is going to But it also says run Prisma format wrapped manually.
Cool.
So yarn Redwood Prisma format. And it added back and saved it for me. And now everyone's happy. Now, the next thing we're going to do, let's talk about the Prisma schema itself. So, this is not JavaScript. It's not even quite GraphQL, but I think the syntax should be fairly simple. You have a model, you have the name of the model, field name, field type, a few more descriptors. This is an ID. It's going to not auto-implement, but automatically generate new ID on each one. We want email to be unique. Name can be whatever you want, may or not be present. And the user will have some posts associated with it. Post is a little more complicated. Got title body created at. You'll see this. This might be, why do you need two different fields for what is really the same thing? This is how Prisma, this is Prisma's schema. This is describes the relation, and this is the actual value the field has access to. And the same for tag. And then your tags, and tags like users will be able to be associated with posts. So, what are we going to do with all that? We're going to build some stuff. So, I've got these three different scaffold commands. So, let's scaffold. Raw, yarn, redwood, generate scaffold for the users. And you're going to notice we're going to get a few errors when it generates the types. Are we? No, it comes with the next one. We generate tags and we'll get the errors. Because some of the relationships with posts doesn't exist yet. There are errors that I'm talking about. What we can look at now, though, is over here a lot has happened. Over an API, here we go, tags and users. These are, see, can't find posts yet. But this is your little schema for tags. This all out of the box. It's going to be able to run queries, hit your GraphQL API, hit, well, in our particular case, it's not using SQLite, but you can very easily put turn on a Docker instance, put in Postgres, and have that work. Not hard to do at all. So we still have to do for tags, for posts. Let me show you the front end what has already been generated for us. So there's a component, not just one component, all of the CRUD components. To edit a tag, create a new tag, to show a tag. I'm sure this is complaining about the post thing. And sometimes its initial formatting is different than what JS wants, and so you'll sometimes get some yellow squigglies. Not yet. There's some yellow squigglies, but I can save it. All right. Moving right along, let's do posts. That was nice and fast. And now you'll see we have post as well. Cool. But you're also going to notice we have a scaffold layout. So this is a layout component. And what this allows us to do are things like this. So now, oh, look at this. If we go back to our homepage, it actually shows you all the different lists of pages by path, which means routes has been updated. Let's go check that. Routes, holy cow. Look at all this. Set is just a way to wrap something in the layout from based upon the route. It's route-based layouts. I believe Next has that too. And it created this all for me. And if we go and take a look, you can see, oh, I want to look at all posts. Cool. Oh, I remember what happened. This, why is that so something went wrong. That's because the database hasn't been initialized. So let's go do that. Yarn, Redwood Prisma, migrate dev. This is going to create a migration, which will not let it name however it wants. It's going to attempt to also see the database. There's nothing there. Let's refresh. It still is not happy. Why is it not happy? That's a kind of start. This is your post listing page for CRUD. Out of the box, I didn't do this, it did this. You can put in, you know, title, programming stuff, and we're not gonna have the ideas, but it doesn't matter what it's gonna be, because it doesn't exist. I might hate that. Yeah, I didn't like the fact that these stuff exist. It doesn't have a better error message, but that has to be okay for now. If we had time later on, I would show you how to create a select box here and pull from what the data you already had, but we don't, and we're not going to, probably not, it doesn't make that long. Let's start right here. So what I am going to do is actually go ahead and grab my seed data, because that'll make it more fun to look at. And where the seeds file initially lives is in the scripts. And this is the, again, the old thing I'll just bring this in. This is for the dry run. I already pasted it, so the demo, scripts, seed. And here you have, this is just the default seed file. Your user example, I'm gonna put in my stuff, save it, and I believe the command is right here. I haven't committed them all to memory. So we'll just see the database. It might yell at me because I have a piece of data. Nope, it didn't. Now, when we go back to posts, yay, we have data. And so this makes it really easy to, you can commit that seed file when you're sharing a project with your buddy. Then you want to have the same starting database. It's right there. You just put it in a C.ts file, and it's there for you. As a bonus, next time you are feeling you need some dummy text, instead of lorem ipsum, we have single Jackson ipsum, Princess Bride ipsum, Star Wars ipsum, and Bacon ipsum. There's all right, so. Back to where we were. Okay, so what are we going to do now? We are going to edit the scaffold layout so that, right, because this is like really big and there's no navigation. How do I get back? How do I get, okay, I can't go from posts. How do I get tags? Well, that's not that hard. I prepared this and let's go over to this scaffold that I did before. I'm going to show you what's in it. Scaffold layout. I just made this little thing over here. So this is just a little bit of HTML and their nav link saying this is going to link to posts, to users, to tags. We installed Tailwind, so you'll, whichever your active one is, will be bold. Cool. Back here, my layout, scaffold layout. Drop this in right above the header. Oh, add that in there. Cool. Hey, we have a little header. And now I can get around. And again, this is like, it really makes it easy for you to find the pieces of information you need once you use that. Moving right along. So, we don't yet have really a homepage, it's this. So maybe, so we're making a blog, right? Let me actually pause right here. How are we doing? Am I? Is it okay? Is it interesting? All right, cool. So I'm just gonna continue like this now. We are going to now, okay, point of information. Let's go down here, look at routes. You could, what is possible is instead of set, or in addition to set, on the outside, there's a component called private, and this allows you, once you set up your authentication, this will prevent access to that set of routes, whatever you wrap in private. Obviously, that's not as that's the front end. It's not as robust as like a back end authentication solution, but that's just how it's working. And I'm sure they have ways to prevent, breaking into the back end. Regardless. But we're not going to get into the authentication today. It's a little beyond the scope of this, but you could like add slash admin and wrap this in private, or is it, there it is, from the Redwood router. Okay, we're not doing that today. Oh, okay. It is covered in the tutorials, though, on their website. So, you're going to, let's create our standard layout, because we still don't want everything to be, but you'll see. We just create the home page. Okay, and then we go back to routes. You'll see this. But we actually want to point to home, so we do that. And now we have a home page.
Almost.
Well, yeah, almost, right? But it's serving, right? Baby steps. But, and we can go to our pages, and we can go to home page, and we can see, oh yeah, that's the thing. Before we go on, talk about tests, right? Jest is built in. You can, every single component, okay, not all of them, not always, normal components that you generate do. But the tests are everywhere. Stories are everywhere. I'm going to generate, you'll see in a second actually. So we're going to generate a standard layout, I'm going to call it. Boom. It generated the three files, the test file and story file. And now if I go, layouts, there it is, standard layout. It's got nothing in it. This is the old one, because it already has some of my, awesome. I'm just gonna be lazy and grab this one, go to my new standard layout, paste it all in there, and now we're gonna look at the homepage. Nothing's happening, because there was an error maybe. Save something, your city. Oh, I know why, because I didn't add it to routes. This also happens separately. So we have to add this set around the routes we want to wrap. So wrap, this would be standard layout. Cool. And now, hey, we got a little demo. But still, this is not really, that's not really enticing. We're gonna have to do something about that. Move along. So did that. Cool. Here's all the data, blah blah blah. Alright, we got our home page. So now we have data, right? We know we have data. We could add a new post. We could edit this and add user ID and tag ID and stuff like that. I'm not going to get into that right now. Okay? And there's no way to get home right now. And of course, we could just add a link to the other layout. And I'm sure you could create a component and share that information about the navigation between the layouts. all of that while it's possible. So now we are going to create a new cell because we want to get the same data that this list of posts get, but we want to show it maybe not at that table, we want to show it as like a list with like the title and maybe a little bit of the body text. You want to put the article date in there, all that stuff's possible. So we're just gonna create that from place. Over here. And it's gonna generate cell. We're gonna take a look at it. Oh, because this is the public posts cell. I got this component. Boom. This is from mocking in Storybook, actually. Let's go look at Storybook. Do we have a look at that? Takes a second. Storybook's a little slow compared to everything else. Shows you the different states. This is coming from our actual component. This is the mocked data. I could, if we changed, it's just doing this. It's just doing the JSON stringify. If we change the data that we were returning, we get different data. It is, however, complaining because we don't actually have a public posts data type. And actually, we're not really planning to do that. I think it makes way more sense to go over here and borrow from the backend part. I'm just gonna copy this query. We know that this is gonna be called, the type is gonna be called find posts. And let's just go move that down over here, right? Here, place that query, take the type, find posts, cool, find posts. Type is called public. Now, using the type though, this is returning posts. Of course, you gotta change the method as well. And now, this won't do anything yet because we haven't added this anywhere. But we can. We're just gonna take this import, put it into the homepage. We're gonna get rid of this silly stuff. There, we're not going to get this. And what we do want, excuse me, is that this won't look like an H1 because it's Tailwind, it was time. And that's unhappy because we probably didn't have the story yet. For the sake of time, I'm just going to go to the drawing board version and grab what I did earlier. I'll show it to you. Components, public post cell. We're just going to drop in title, slide a little bit, pop truncated body, and a reward link. Cool, we can do that. This, you may wonder why I'm getting this. I don't know. from the forum. It doesn't stop anything from working, but even if I do things like window or memory start, it goes away for a second, and then when I save it, it goes back. I don't know. But it doesn't stop from working. Ooh. We haven't added this post. It's trying to create this link to nowhere. So we have to go grab that. We have to create that and fix, and in doing so, and then modify the route. Cool. Let's go borrow a command for creating. We're going to create a single. First, let's just create a page. It is the page we're trying to get to. The page has the route. So, we'll go over. I'm going to stop Storybook. Need it right now. Cool. I got myself page. We can go to routes and see where it is. Yeah, the page. I want to put it into the standard layout, of course. And what I want to do is mimic this. I want to be able to have it take parameter. Cool. Now what's going to happen? Now we've got the design. Paste the chart loosely. And we go, oh, it is still not happy. Missing parameter. Public post, so. This is the same issue as before, where we need to get the actual individual post by ID. I'll bet it's not doing that. I bet it's doing something else, yeah. Also, different query, because it's trying to find this public post query, and I want to duplicate the query and all that stuff. So I'm going to take what I did earlier, using find post by ID, which is based upon the original scaffolding of posts, so that I don't have to have duplicate GraphQL types and resolvers. And I'll let this stop, which is why it's yelling at me. Can't resolve another post. This doesn't make any sense. I forget to save something. Yeah, I don't have the actual. I made an actual component earlier for the other post just to say how it's going to look. Yes, I did. Oh, okay. very, very quickly. Yarn generate component. Post. Cool, it made it for us. There it is. I'm just going to replace the markup so that it looks nice. Now I've got my title on my body. There are just a million other things which we are just not. That was one about the third party API. Just gonna open this for y'all. So here's a tutorial, here's a reference. They cover so much. Migrations, deployments, add the environmental variables, local Postgres, mocking GraphQL requests. There's stuff on logging, testing you saw. It does as webpack, already configured for you, works out of the box. Anyway, this is like, I believe that's like in a nutshell, that is that's Redwood. And so now I guess I have a slide, but for questions. But I think I'm gonna pause now and see who has questions. Yes, sir. No, please. Someone have a question.
Okay.